It's truly, it was at first it was just a real shock and disbelief when the film was leaked, you know, and then you sort of go through a stage of being really angry, and then you feel almost sorry for the idiot that did it, because you wonder if it was just some, I still don't know, and the FBI are looking at, I don't know who did it. I mean, was it just some kid who thought this would be cool and showed it to a mate who sent it out, or was it someone who really stole it from us for financial gain? At this point, we still don't know. All I can say is to everybody out there, first of all, thank you to the vast majority of the internet community for actually saying this was not a good thing to do, and for saying, guys, this is not how you want to see the movie. Mm. I mean, everybody is judged on how they make a movie when it's done. None of us directors can escape the critics. They're coming, like it or not. But boy, it's uncomfortable to feel you're going to be judged on something that you weren't ready, you know, you weren't ready to be judged on. It's like someone nicking your exam at school or college or something before you finished and saying, I'm going to grade you now. You go, whoa, give me a break. So I was terribly disappointed and felt obviously somewhat exposed and like you're seeing this half-baked stuff. But as I say, most people have been unbelievably supportive and hopefully they go to see the movie the way we wanted them to see it. Big screen, big sound. It's Wolverine, for God's sake. You can't watch him on a computer screen. I don't know that we consciously did that. I mean, those were in the script, and I think that, as you know, this face that Victor draws is something that's quite iconic to him. Mm-hmm. So I think somewhere the comic books have drawn on each other out there. So no, it wasn't something we did consciously, but of course no art exists in a vacuum. No creativity exists in a vacuum. We're all kind of drawing on each other, where we realize it or not. So there are wonderful things in the movie, though, that were conscious tips to the fan, which maybe we can point out. I mean, I had one fan on the site. You know, I do go and look at these things kind of nervously. But I'm like, what do they say? The one guy was adamant, like, I hope they don't screw this up. I hope they know that Gambit has red eyes.
Yeah.
And if he doesn't have red eyes, I'm going to screw this character. Well, you look in the comics, you know, which is a comic book world, and we're setting this story more in the real world. And I'm going, he has red eyes in there, and I put him red eyes. Everybody's going to say, you want the eye drops? You okay, mate? So I thought, we can't do that. But as a nod to the fans, we do that shot, which I rather like. It pushes in right on the eyes as Gambit's dislike of Wolverine is building, and the eyes glow red just for a second. There are a lot of those. If you look at Stryker's lapel for the hardcore fans, when Stryker's in the hospital corridor, there's a little, religious symbol, just so people know that we do know that he was a crazy evangelical preacher. But in this particular story, that's not overly played on. Fantastic. So for the hardcore guys, go dig around. Three pipes coming into the adamantium tank.
Oh, right,
three types going in, one adamant made from three different, you know.
There you go.
There you go.
Multiple viewings.